happy to freaking Cinco Star Wars. It's Star Wars Day. Hi, welcome to Weird News. I'm Patrick Weir, and this is Weird News. This past week and all over the world, people celebrated Cinco de Mayo, National Star Wars Day, in countries such as America. You got them celebrating in Mexico. You had people just butt-chugging in Maryland. Hell, even North Korea was showing their appreciation for the Star Wars films. I mean, they care so much about those movies, they try to make rocket ships a real thing. The frickin' mad lads.
Turning now to more breaking news overnight, North Korea firing a barrage of short-range missiles into the Sea of Japan.
Our precious little Cheeto Puff in the White House seemed to show his appreciation for the Star Wars by praising North Korea for their actions.
The president optimistic he can still get a deal, tweeting, "I believe that Kim Jong-un fully realizes the great economic potential of North Korea and will do nothing to interfere or end it," adding, "He also knows that I am with him and does not want to break his promise to me. Deal will happen."
Oh, great. Our president is with the dictator who imprisons, tortures, and executes his own people, sometimes going as far to attach his people to the end of an anti-aircraft gun, blowing them to pieces, and then having tanks roll through and smush whatever pieces that are left of what was once a living human being who had family and friends. And look, I love Star Wars just as much as the next fella, okay? I mean, we're talking Jar Jar. We're talking Rose. If I were to make a tier list video of the best Star Wars characters, those two would definitely be in my S tier. If you know what I'm saying. I'm saying I would suck their dick. Star Wars aside, I thought Donald Trump wasn't a fan of the Little Rocket Man.
We can't have Mad Men out there shooting rockets all over the place. Little Rocket Man, he may be smart, he may be strategic, and he may be totally crazy. But you know what? No matter what he is, we're gonna handle it, folks. Believe me, we're gonna handle it.
Yeah, good job, Trump. You handled the situation. I mean, poorly and unsuccessfully, but you did handle it. I just want to know what's changed since the days that Trump would launch, you know, these crazy Twitter rants about Kim Jong-un. To absolutely nobody's surprise, though, Kim Jong-un is not the only leader of a hostile country that Trump has been all buddy-buddy with this past week.
President Trump and Russian President Vladimir Putin have spoken for the first time since the release of the Mueller report. They briefly talked about the Russia probe, but Mr. Trump said he did not warn Putin not to meddle in next year's election.
He is so stupid. So Donald Trump called Vladimir Putin, and they had a little girls chat for about an hour or so. And this is what Donald Trump had to say whenever he was questioned if he had discussed the findings in the Mueller report with Vladimir Putin.
Mr. President, did you address the election meddling issues that came up in the Mueller report with Mr. Putin today?
We discussed that he actually sort of smiled when he said something to the effect that it started off as a mountain and it ended up being a mouse, but he knew that because he knew there was no collusion.
He smiled at you through the phone. Buddy, I don't think you're talking to Boone. I think you passed out and then you were chased around by a nightmare pedophile. What's really concerning, though, about Donald Trump's phone call with Vladimir Putin is the fact that Trump still seems to be buying in to this narrative that the Russians of Vladimir Putin had nothing to do with the interference in our 2016 election. He's been saying that the Russians had nothing to do with it ever since he met with Vladimir Putin back in Helsinki.
People came to me, Dan Coats came to me and some others. They said they think it's Russia. President Putin. He just said it's not Russia. I will say this. I don't see any reason why it would be. I have great confidence in my intelligence people, but I will tell you that President Putin was extremely strong and powerful in his denial today.
So now, given the perfect opportunity for Donald Trump to tell Vladimir Putin on the phone, that, hey, you stop it. Stop it. Nope, no more. No more interference. No more. A-ba-ba-ba. Yeah, whatever that was. Instead of that, Donald Trump just chose not to even bring it up.
Did you ask him not to meddle in the next election?
We didn't discuss that. Really, we didn't discuss it.
Why not tell Russia no more of these shenanigans in 2020? You know, why doesn't Trump believe his intelligence agencies over Vladimir Putin, the person who orchestrated the entire thing? Well, he wants there to be more interference in 2020. It's how he won 2016. why not stick with the same plan? The Mueller report revealed that time and time again, the Russians did assist the Trump campaign. The only thing that we do not have is inconclusive evidence that, you know, Donald Trump scribbled with some crayon on a piece of paper and handed it to Vladimir Putin and it read something like, hey, I want to commit some crimes? If you were walking down the street and a man came up to you and he said, hey, bud, you want this bag of crystal meth? And then you don't say no, and then he gives it to you, and then you smoke it, and you get arrested. Whenever you're in court and the judge is like, did you indeed or did you not indeed smoke that crystal meth? You couldn't just say, well, I didn't ask for the meth, so is it a crime? That is not a viable legal argument. The judge would say, yes, I'm hammering my gavel to show you, yes, it is a crime. However, with all that being said, you know, that's probably just my liberal snowflake socialist comet ping pong card carrying member dumb dumb liberal brain, you know, who thinks that way. I'm sure there's gotta be a great reason as to why Donald Trump acted like such a gigantic pussy. Here's what the Secretary of State Mike Pompeo had to say on the matter.
I talk to leaders all the time. We cover a broad range of subjects. Sometimes conversations just aren't long enough to include every issue that might be brought up.
Yeah, but what about when you're on the phone with the leader of a country who successfully interfered with one of your presidential elections, undermining your democracy, the very principles your country was founded on? What about then, Mike? Don't you think that might come up, I don't know, once or twice, Mike? To be fair, I don't know why Fox News is the one that's questioning Mike Pompeo about why Donald Trump couldn't focus on an hour-long phone call. Fox News knows better than anybody else how difficult it is to try to keep Donald Trump streamlined on a phone conversation.
And by the way, I made them a fortune with The Apprentice. Think of that one. I made them and I did
nicely. Your alma mater.
No, but I made them a fortune.
Right.
You people say you're still looking good, Mr. President.
Still,
how do you do it? And they'll have a council of seven people. And of the seven people, every one of them is against me. I'm saying, where do we? Right. Where do they even find? And it works very well. But
Mr.
last
President,
night, I did watch a liar leaker for their loss of the Electoral College that they should never lose, not the nonsense of collusion with Russia.
Well, we could talk to you all day, but it looks like you have a million things to do. But I hope you could join us again, Mr.
Thank
President.
Thank you so much for being here.
You know, I think he was awake, and he had a lot to say.
It's obvious, though, that Trump and the entire GOP's plan is kind of just try to ignore this entire Russian investigation and hope the whole thing blows over. So here's what we've learned from the currently redacted Mueller report. It was confirmed yet again that the Russians did indeed interfere with our 2016 presidential election. It says on page one of the report, the Russian government interfered in the 2016 presidential election in sweeping and systematic fashion. The report also stated that had the special counsel found the evidence to exonerate the president for obstruction of justice, they would have done so. But, they didn't. And also, we learned that William Barr lied to the American public about the contents of the report with the bullshit summary that he put out 4 days before actually releasing the redacted report, giving the media plenty of time to spread around this message that the president's exonerated. So William Barr has just proven to us that he's not America's attorney general, he's really just another lawyer for Donald Trump. Now, William Barr's defense for, you know, lying under oath to Congress is really just that his summary wasn't a summary, it was just kind of stuff.
So somebody offered to them that they could review your summary, make comments.
It wasn't a summary, it was a statement of the principal conclusions. It wasn't a summary of the report.
Okay.
The number one issue with that, though, there is in the summary, it says it's a summary. William Barr is so bad at properly representing the information on a document that he can't even properly summarize his own summary that he wrote. However, not everybody feels the way I do. You know, we got some patriots in the GOP who somehow managed to brown-nose Donald Trump even deeper than they were before, to where it's really just gotten to the point where they're basically wearing the man as a mascot costume. When questioned about bringing in the man, the myth, the Mueller himself to testify, this is what Lindsey Graham had to say.
Why not call for Mueller to testify?
Because I'm not going to do any more. Enough already. It's over. If there's any dispute about a conversation, then he'll come. But I'm not going to retry the case. I'm not calling McCann. It is over.
Were you trying to say to the Obama administration?
Thank God a senator is finally putting down his foot and using that ability all senators have to decide what the entire legislative branch is going to do. Lindsey Graham gets it! Lindsey Graham is so far in the closet that he's clenching up his butt cheeks so he doesn't accidentally blow a load of decade-old yogurt from taking a shit. But Lindsey, all that built-up dookie is really starting to rise out of you and spill out of your mouth, and buddy, you're starting to smell like shit. So So while Lindsey Graham ran away to go angrily bake some cookies in his treehouse, we had other people such as Senator John Kennedy, who was giving William Barr the real hardball questions.
I want to know first, has the Mueller team changed its mind on its conclusions as to collusion, conspiracy, conspiracy?
Not that I'm aware of.
The decision not to bring an indictment against the president for collusion, conspiracy with Russia has not changed?
No, it hasn't.
And the conclusion not to bring an indictment against the president for obstruction of justice has not changed?
No.
Robert Mueller didn't indict the president, now he still hasn't indicted the president? Good job there, John Kennedy. I guess this entire thing's pretty cut and dry then, isn't it? Well, we can wipe our hands with this and be done with it. I guess I'm just kidding. It's not cut, and it's moist as fuck. You see, the Office of Legal Counsel has held this position for a very long time now that you cannot indict a sitting president. This came up in 1973 with Richard Nixon, and then again in 2000 with Bill Clinton. And every single time, the Office of Legal Counsel has held the same position. You can't indict a sitting president. And I'm not saying I agree with that, but that's just the way our country has worked for the last, I don't know, 60 years or so. So there's either one or two things happening here with Mr. Kennedy. One, he doesn't know how his own job works. Or two, he knows that, but he's purposely just spinning this narrative to further spread misinformation amongst the American public. Either way, between these two, he should not be qualified to be a fucking lawmaker. The silver lining in this orange cloud that's looming over America's head is the fact that the House Judiciary Committee will possibly have Mueller testifying before them as early as next week, and on top of that, they're also planning to hold William Barr in contempt of court if he does not release an unredacted Mueller report to them, which is happening tomorrow, the day after I'm shooting this, so the day that this is coming out. To sum it all up, North Korea is trolling our president, Russia is trolling our president, and our president is trolling all of us. Doesn't really matter though, you know, our planet is slowly dying and we are all going to burn with it.